My name is Devon Terrell. I'm the living weirdo. I'm gonna sing you a song today. I really hope you like it.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, baby, when I turn it on. All through my city, all through my home. We're flying up, no ceiling when we in our zone. Ain't nobody surround me or hold me down. You give it, they wear it out like a hand-me-down. Got my eyes, my lungs, heat up, they froze. I'm back at it again, I got everybody like damn Daniel, yeah. Crazy when people in your city start to know, yeah. When you on fire, you don't stop, drop or roll, yeah. Put it on my haters in pocket, treat them like loose change. I'm on my own way. Ride with me, hold up, look at how my whole life built up. Changing like a Snapchat filter. Ready, willing, able, I'm finally feeling stable. I've been waiting all my life and here I am. I'm in here feeling the vibe. Just imagine. Nothing I can see but you when you dance, dance, dance. Feel the good, good creeping up on you.
Yo, what up? It's your boy Greg Fountain. Man, I'm out here grinding. Just running some errands. Had to do some banking just now. Now I gotta head over to another bank. Might pick up some groceries from my mom. So, yeah, today's going well. It's cloudy as shit outside, man. It looks like it's gonna rain a little bit, so I'm trying to get it all done. Before I go to lunch a little bit late. I'm supposed to go to lunch about 3. I know it's a little late lunch, but it's all good because I got up a little late anyways. So I got some things I got to do, man. I got to run to the bank. Got to print out some stuff for some tax purposes. Man, I'm excited. Today's going to be another good day. I got to get the vlog edited and uploaded. It's been a couple days. I was supposed to get it up yesterday, but I got into a good movie and took some medicine, and I went to sleep. Because your boy is trying to get a regular sleep schedule going, which is all gonna change once I start working. But I'm okay with that, because I'm good at all times. Daytime, nighttime, in between time. So, what was I say? Oh, yeah, so yesterday had some pretty big news. I didn't really talk about it on the vlog, because I did it on my Facebook Live, but those of you guys that have been following the vlog know that I have been trying to recently get a hold of somebody at Best Bet Jacksonville, which is the poker room here in my city. And as you know, I did get the job in Daytona for the poker dealer position because I passed my audition. Awesome, cool. But I was trying to figure out a way to get an audition here in Jacksonville, because the ideal situation would be me to work as a dealer in Jacksonville so I don't have to move. You know, I don't have to spend all that money commuting. I'd rather have a 10-minute drive than an hour and a half drive. You know, those kind of things. So I've been jumping through hoops the last 5-6 days trying to just get a hold of somebody that that knows who I should talk to. So after about 8 different phone calls, 2 trips up to the poker room, talking to various people, I finally got a hold of the right person, man. And that's just what we're talking about. We've been talking about knocking down doors or finding a window to get in. And it looked like I was getting to run around for a little bit, but evidently they end up sending me in the right direction. I was going about it all wrong. I thought the people that work at the poker room could actually hire me and get me an audition, but I gotta go to HR. So I had to go through HR, talk to bunch of different people in HR, and finally I found my lady, and she set me up with an audition, a group audition, just like I did in Daytona, an audition for next Friday, 12 o'clock at Best Bet. So I have a chance to go 2 for 2 in auditions. I'm really excited about it. I've been practicing every day dealing with my cards. I need to go and pick up some chips so I can practice dealing with some chips too, so that'll be helpful. So I may run and go do that today. I may go get like $100 worth of chips or something just so I can practice at home. And of course I'd end up cashing that back in next week or this week, whatever. but I think it would be really helpful if I went and got some chips so I can work on cutting checks and all this other stuff. But anyways, not gonna make this part of it too long. I'm excited to have another good day. You know, see what happens. I get to go, like I said, I get to go have some sushi later for lunch. Yes! I made a good breakfast this morning. It was high protein packed, low fat, just good stuff, man, healthy stuff. And so I'm gonna start looking out at my diet again, got to get in this gym eventually, but it'll all just be better if I can manage to lock down this job, because then I can build around it. I can build up my bankroll again, so I can get on the road traveling to play some tournaments around the country, and so I can just go to some various spots playing poker and get ahead on the bills, help my mom out, you know, just the things I really have been wanting to do, I'll be able to do, because I'm living by my terms once again, you know what I mean? I'm not having to schedule things and worry about putting money in other people's pockets right now. I can finally really work on myself. So I'm out here, gonna pay some bills, keep that thing moving. All right, catch you in a minute. Your boy is heading to lunch now with the pops. Get some sushi, because that's what we do, see? Sushi, do see? Because it's juicy, you know? But, that was terrible. Shut up! But anyways, I went grocery shopping earlier, man. There was so many deals. I was like, I'm going to go in there and spend about $20. Cool. So many deals, your boy spent like $78. But the difference about my $78 and other people's $78 is that $78 is going to last me for at least 2 weeks. I'm going to be eating good at least 2 weeks off $78. Now, if you eat out every single day, $10 a day, in a week, you're almost going to spend that same amount. Right? Right. And that's for one meal per day. Right? Because lunch could be $6, $7, $8, $9, $10, depending on where you go. But I'll eat three meals a day for 2 weeks. That's what I'm talking about. So, just got some news, just got an email from Daytona. They're telling me that my orientation is February 3rd, 9 a.m. Fun fact, the orientation is the same day as the audition that I'm trying to do. What? So, ain't this some shit? I don't really mind, though. Hopefully there's another orientation. I did send an email back saying that I won't be able to make that orientation because I already have something locked down for the day. But you know what? Life is a gamble. If they say, sorry, that's the only time we can go, then better hope that I pass this damn audition, huh? But there usually is other orientations, not just that Friday. So hopefully there's one before or one after. Who knows? We gonna see, though. We gonna see. But I'm really excited about... Damn, it's raining. It's raining. Is it raining where you're at? Man, it's raining right here. I'll tell you that right now. Florida, it'll be raining for 10 minutes and be dry and hot as hell for the next 10 hours. But back to what we was doing. You know what I mean? Back to what we was doing. So I'm excited at the chance to be successful and live the life that I want to live, because I live under my own damn rules. I haven't had a boss in so long. I might have somebody in charge when I get hired. I may have somebody that's in charge, but he doesn't run my life. He may say, you're scheduled to work this day, this day, this day, but I have the option to say, no, I quit. So think about it that way. You may have somebody that's in charge, somebody that gives you guidelines and a set of rules, but you still make your own choices. Yes, there's consequences to good choices and bad choices, but there's consequences, good and bad. But you should make your choices based off how you feel, you know? If you're not happy, you gotta do something about it. That doesn't mean quit and go find another job. Find a way to get through that so that you can get back to your happiness, your peaceful place. I don't know, you may need a man cave. You may need to upgrade your cable package so you can go home and watch better shows. I don't know. But I just wanted to get some of those things off my chest. Another pet peeve. I'm throwing this out there. Women. Young women especially. Those of you guys are all over Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, smoking weed and acting like that's the cool thing to do. And got your whole face pierced and your boobies out all the time. And think that that's appealing. What mom wants their son to bring you home to them? Just think about that. That doesn't demand respect to me. But you know what? I do know people that do that. I'm not judging. You're just not the right one for me. There's a lot of people out there that love you guys. That's why you do it, obviously. You got your goodies all out there because you get the attention. Because you got your goodies. You're smoking on that stuff because it might make you feel good or you think it's a cool thing to do. hey, do what you do, you know? Cool. I just choose not to do it. Not saying I haven't done it in the past. I didn't put it on Facebook, I tell you that. You know, everyone tries stuff sometimes. I'm not saying yes I have or no I haven't. Don't say nothing. But to me, that's just not the cool thing to do. I'm not judging. I have plenty of friends that do it. I just don't hang out with them when they do. If you gotta do it, get down how you get down. But your boy's just saying that's not really the most attractive thing. Oh, bitches. It's not really that cool. It's not that cool. It's not that cool. You think it's cool? It's not really that cool. Nope. 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 Anyways, heading to get some good food, that's what's cool. Relationships, that's what's cool. Heading to go hang out with my pops. Haven't hung out with them in a while. Haven't seen them in a while. I want to hang out with them. Some of this stuff might not even make it to the vlog. But you know what? We're going to say it anyways because we're not censored. Not up in here. We say what we're going to say. That's what we say. Yep.
So I'm here with my pops, about to get something to eat. First time to the vlog, there he is, man right there.
What's up?
What's up? So it's a sashimi fusion. Boom. So we're gonna take it inside, get something to eat. I know I won't be the first one giving you all this attention. Baby, listen. Yo, so I'm out here at the gas station getting some gas, you know. It's what we run on. We don't run on Dunkin', we run on gas. But had food with the pops. Sushi was great. It's nice to sit down and talk to him and just give him updates on what's going on. See how he's doing, see how I'm doing. But about to go home and got done eating. Now I'm gonna go home and cook. Yeah, that's how I get down. Go ahead and cook a little bit. And have something good to eat for later. $20. That's all my tank needed. $20.